Hello lovely bookworms, this is Kavita Sharma here. In this video, I'll be talking about a book that I read recently, That Thing About You by Abhay Deen. If you're looking for a romantic fiction with a bit of fantasy elements in it, then this book is for you. This is not actually a romantic fiction, we can call it as an insightful book which tells you about yourself and which makes you think from another perspective. If you want to know more about this book, then let us go into the video. Let me first talk about the storyline which attracted me a lot, because the storyline is very different with a lot of fantasy elements in it. I can call it as a magical realism book with insightful thoughts. Why I call this book as an insightful book? Because this book makes you view yourself from another perspective. We have a young man, Subhat, as a protagonist in this novel. This protagonist is very immature to this age, and also he has no goal about his life. He follows what society has taught him in very stereotypical way. And Subhat's disposition is not like a man in his late 20s. Rather, his disposition is like a teenage boy who gets offended at everything, who gets emotional at every incident. So how does Subhat say change himself? You know, we view many characters like this who will not take advice from anyone. They take everything personally. So the author introduces a fantasy element in this book to change the Subhat's disposition and to make him view his life from another perspective. What is that fantasy element? Are you really intrigued? Even I was intrigued when I was reading this book. In the initial point of this novel, Subhat falls in love with his colleague Sneha. He thinks that he has a pretty good wavelength with Sneha, and also he definitely wants to propose her. When he decides to propose her, he overhears a conversation of Sneha and her friend Anu talking about Subhat. In that conversation, Sneha remarks that Subhat is an immature man and she cannot imagine Subhat as her boyfriend. This offends Subhat and he acts again like a teenage boy who gets emotional at every incident. After hearing the conversation of Sneha and Anu, Subhat distances himself from Sneha and he doesn't talk with her. This irritates Sneha a lot. After all these bitter incidents, when Subhat sits alone in a swing, he hears a mysterious voice of a woman. His frustration makes him reply to that woman, and also he starts a conversation with that mysterious voice. He cannot view who that person talking to him, and also he doesn't mind to answer all these questions, the sensible questions arising inside his mind. His loneliness and his frustration makes him get emotionally attached to that voice, and eventually he names it as Kalpana. That mysterious voice advises Subhat, and Subhat is not refusing to hear all the advice. He is very much intrigued to know about himself from that invisible person. But in reality, you cannot hear a mysterious voice like that, and people will think you are imagining stuffs and you are mentally ill. So are the colleagues of Subhat. They think Subhat is imagining stuffs because of the conversation he heard. But for Subhat, the voice is very real. He feels that this is not a figment of his imagination. What magic did God create in Subhat's life? And how did Subhat hear that voice? To know answers for all these questions, you should definitely read That Thing About You by Abhay Deen. When I read this book, I thought this is a magical realism work with expected ending, but it is not like that. The ending was unexpected, and it is an amazing fiction work with beautiful imagination. And I really got amazed by the conversation between Kalpana and Subhat. The conversations are real, and also you can find about yourself in those conversations. And also, while talking about the character of Subhat, what I felt is the author could have elaborated a bit about his gradual development in mental state and also how he changed himself. So this is the thing I felt while reading this book, but even though I was very happy when Subhat changes himself. Another thing that I liked about this book is author's imagination. If he had concentrated more on the narrative style and also on the side characters' development, this book would have been the best. But nevertheless, if you're looking for a magical realism book and a fiction with sweet fantasy elements in it, then I would recommend this book for you. And also, you cannot tell about this book without any spoilers, because you have many twists and turns in this book. That is the special thing that I really liked a lot. And I would recommend this book not only for the beginners but also for every reader. You can go grab this copy, That Thing About You by Abhay Deb.